everyone, and welcome to the Nürburgring Easter Drift Cup, three games of sideways madness. As of this year, the main difference in comparison to previous years is that the competitors have been divided in two different classes, namely the club and the pro. And I'd like to tell you first about the club class. And usually you would think club, pro, so probably something entry-level class, stock car. But no, actually, this car, you would think a huge turbo sticking out of the hood should be in the pro class, right? No, wrong. This is a club car because the main difference is that the pro cars are allowed to run semi-slicks, and in this case the driver of this car decided not to go too crazy, although the level of this car allows it to compete in the pro class because the engine is M50, 2.5 liter engine from BMW in the Ford Sierra, and again on top a huge turbo which makes 450 crank horsepower, which is enough, but maybe not enough for the semi-slicks, and especially in today's weather conditions it's even running winter tires. And the second point of the difference regarding regulations is the driver skill. All the pro drivers are actually experienced drivers from the previous years, and the club drivers are novice or advanced drivers, but the cars who cannot handle the semi-slicks. And then there is the pro class, and although on the outside appearance of the cars you cannot tell much difference between the club and pro, but once you take off the bonnet or the hood of the car you can see, for example, this is BMW E46 M3 or something that it used to be, but now there is a Toyota 2JZ engine which is also far from being stock. Currently this car is running 725, wait for it, wheel horsepower, and thereby this car needs semi-slicks. And this is the only difference between the club and the pro class, because in the pro class you are allowed to run semi-slicks to handle all those extra horsepower. And the other difference is the skill level of the driver. Apart from the engine, you can see also a lot of more crazy mods. For example, this car has sequential gearbox, it has radiator in the back, and plenty of more. But I can go on for hours about the mods of the car, but just have a look how it looks like. Now, of course, Nürburgring offers multiple track configurations, including the world-famous Nordschleife, but Nürburgring Drift Cup is taking place on the GP track, and to be more precise, on Müllenbachschleife. So the cars start at the Dunlop curve. Then they need to initiate the drift at the first part of Schumacher S-corner. But the best, or actually the most exciting part of the track is this, the Little Monaco. And just like the world famous Formula One track, cars get very close to the barrier. Drop it like that. The beauty of the Nürburgring Drift Cup is the variety of participants. You have people from Germany, Holland, Scandinavia, Switzerland, you name it. But probably the most interesting part is that you would think that a motorsport is a man's sport in general, but Denise proves the contrary of it. We know each other already for a couple of years, but for a new audience, maybe you can introduce yourself quickly.
Yeah, I'm Denise Ritvan. I'm from Germany. I drive since 2009. And now since last year we have a M3 compressor in the car with 435 horsepower. And this winter we changed many things on the suspension, and now we are also getting the grip. Mm-hmm. And now we are really fast.
Yeah, speaking of fast, we just saw your entry at the last qualification round. That looked quite spectacular. Could you tell us what happened?
Yeah, we were in the first run. We were a little bit too fast and we are getting a zero. The second run was a safe run and we are getting 72 points. And we said, okay, it's enough. We can go now full throttle up the hill and maybe it get a 90 point or it's getting a zero. And the entry was like 155 kilometers an hour. It was a perfect entry. But we were a little bit too fast and then we are in the gravel. But
the speed was fine, but the corner was too tight. The famous words. Are you the only girl at Nürburgring Drift Cup?
No, we are two girls. There's Bianca Lankas. Mm-hmm. She's driving in the club class. And she did today really, really good because mm-hmm. they had hard weather. Yep. And she was sixth place, I think. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So what tip would you give to girls who want to enter motorsports or drifting in particular?
Just come and drive and don't think about what should the people do, what should the people think about me. Just go and drive.
That's it. Good, thank you.
You're welcome. Yeah.
After all the training and qualifying, we have come down to the top 16 and it's time to decide who is the number one by so-called sudden death method. So this means top 16s battle one against one and then the winner continues to the next round. So from 16 to 8 to 4 to 2 and finally we will have the winner. Let's have a look. Congratulations with your win. You're all the way from Denmark?
No, not Denmark, yes.
From Denmark? Yes. Did you expect to come here and win?
I hope to be in the grade 8, I think.
Okay.
This is the best.
This is the best. So, are you going to come back to Nürburgring Drift Cup?
Yeah, well, I hope we'll ride the whole series this year.
Oh, that's perfect. So hopefully there's going to be more. Is this your first time competing here at the Nürburgring?
I was been here two times last year.
Okay.
It went well, but not as good as this one.
Yeah, I saw also you had a small technical issue on the top four, when you're battling for the top four, and you fixed it last moment. You only had 2 minutes to fix it, and you managed. So I think you can say that you have a very good team as well.
Yeah, very good.
Yeah.
Cool. We bend the wheel and then you just throw it back and it's like, oh, that's okay, drive.
Yeah. Perfect. Well, another congratulations and looking forward to see you next time.
Thank you.
Good.
Thank
you. So, Bas, congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Second place.
Yeah, very excited.
You told me that you have some new mods on this car. You have sequential gearbox, radiator in the back. How did they benefit you this time?
Well, the sequential gearbox gave me the opportunity to shift between gears very quickly and also adapt to my opponent very quickly. If he goes a little bit faster, I can switch up a gear in a matter of seconds. So that really helped me to get a nice close proximity throughout all the battles.
Yeah, I saw you also got an award for the best chase, I believe.
Yes, that's correct. Yeah,
I was standing at the Little Monaco and you was always catching up with people. I also saw in the final run that you even actually had a small bump with your opponent because you were a bit of too fast.
Yeah, I was trying to be at his door as close as possible. However, I was a little bit too excited.
Okay.
Which ended up in a little scratch, but it was an amazing battle. And it was an amazing battle. The opponents were awesome. The weather was great. It was an awesome event. Really happy with the results, and really looking forward to the next event.
Perfect. We're looking forward to see you next time at the big entry.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. Congratulations, and see you next time.
Thank you.
Well, as you can see, everyone is packing up, so I'd like to thank everyone who made this event what it was. All the drivers for amazing atmosphere, the organizations, the sponsors, and all I can say, I'm looking forward to see you guys here again at the Nürburgring Drift Cup second round, the big entry on 18th of May. Thanks for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed and let us know if you want to have something special covered for the next round. See you. Bye-bye.